our local music that would have been featured internationally. And so we're going to show you a couple of clips. Listen to the music and we'll have a brief discussion. We may have one or two in the room with us right now, right?
Yeah, we do have one or two in the room with us, and they have no clue that we're doing this.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, right. This is fun. So the title of this segment is From Soundtrack to Stardom, Those Who Did It. So we're recognizing those persons locally that did it. And what is the did it? Sync. This conversation for the past 3 days is about sync in its various forms, music and film. Those who did it, let's take a look at the first clip.
Yes, so you can play the first clip for the audience.
Improvise. Look.
So as
put
we
up
wait,
on your hand
we
now.
Are
show
going
me
to
on your hand now. Love is what we're fighting for.
That's sophisticated.
Remove ya!
Put up all your hand now, show me all your hand now. Let me see the hand them who don't want no war, war, war. Put up all your hand now, show me all your hand now. Love is what we fighting for.
Love is a splendid thing. What a great joy that it bring. More precious than a diamond ring. Loving in my heart make me sing.
Oh, 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 oh. Show me all your hand now. Let me see the hand them who don't wanna war, war, war. Put up all your hand now. Show me all your hand now. Love is what we fighting for. Put up all your hand now. Show me all your hand now. Let me see the hand them who don't wanna war, war, war. Put up all your hand now. Show me all your hand now. Love is what we fighting for.
Love is a splendid thing. What a great joy that it bring. Loving in my heart make me sing. Put up all your hand now, every queen and king.
Put up all your hand now, show me all your hand now. Let me see the hand them who don't wanna war, war, war. Put up all your hand now, show me all your hand now. Love is what we fighting for.
Now if you have not seen Vasily, you can go online on streaming platforms. It's on Pavilion Plus as well. And you can look at Vasily. And what we're looking at, Alex Vanwell would have worked with Marshall Montano and his team in terms of doing the Vasily film and the beauty of it in terms of putting our music into a movie, you're able to now showcase internationally. And Vasily streamed, it went to at least 40 to 50 cinemas internationally showcasing, and they also screened in India as well. And so we're showing the reach in terms of our local music showcasing internationally.
Yeah. So I'll add a little caveat to that, right? So I had never watched Vasily up until like two, three weeks ago.
Melissa.
So Leslie decided, all right, no, this is a no-no, Melissa. We're so going no-no. To have a whole day lunchtime in the office where we go down in the boardroom and we feature this film. So the whole staff came downstairs, everybody with their lunch, and we had film. So we decided that we're going to go forward with one local film every month.
Yes, we're going to have lunch and lime.
Yes, lunch and lime in the office, right, for Creative TT.
To look at our local films. And of course, our second one, do you want to go to our next?
Sure. Let's hit our second clip, folks.
The body is an infinitely complex mass of interacting systems. People like to think doctors see it all clearly. But it's not always obvious what's a hiccup in the system and what's a full-on medical disaster.
If you're ready for the road, let your friend them know. We're ready for the road.
We figure that out in our first year of residency.
Hey, you sleep okay?
Great. We spend the rest of our careers lying about it.
I probably can't write about this in the article, but something about how my toothpaste hit the sink made me realize that the array could be designed asymmetrically.
makes it more versatile.
Exactly.
So what you're saying is that you can't spit without having a genius idea.
Oh, well, it may not work.
Zola, are your songs
I feel like that's in the structure,
a revolutionary global spit.
All right. So
if you...
What is the name of this series? All right, just wanted to know something was wrong, yeah? All right, and whose music is being performed here? Well, played here? Bungie Gallard? I like your little child voice. Yeah, so this one actually happened 10 years ago, and the Made Waves with Trinidad was like, hey, hey, everybody, because everybody was watching Grey's Anatomy at that point, right? So it's like, hey, hey, hey. Well, they had a soca song they're playing inside of there. So when talking to Sheriff about it, he's like, yeah, we didn't know that was going to happen. Why? Because they had their rights in order and all of that. So the publishers would have been the one to, you know, see all of this. So they just like, oh, okay. It popped up inside of there. So, you know, again, to Marte's point earlier from the panel before, if you have your stuff in order, you're making money literally through sync while you sleep.
Exactly. And every time that particular episode plays, based on the rights they would have
negotiated,
they will get a bit of coin every single time. And that's the value of it. So our next one, and those who did it.
Right, so let's go to the next one.
Let's go to the next one.
Lord Chester, roll up to the city, you're the whip sitting sideways, speeding in the lane, doing donuts on the highway. Haters gonna hate when I'm pulling out my driveway. Pretty girl driving by, and they looking my way. We mash gas like a speed racer. These girls, they looking like some cloud chasers. We mash gas like a speed racer. Cause you ain't nothing but a cloud chaser.
Who is the person singing?
Who are we listening to?
Who is the person singing? You want to ask them when it happened?
When did this happen?
None of you know?
All right.
Which means none of all you are following him on social. So I want all you to pull out all your phones now and add him
What's
to your
handle?
Social.
Give them your handle.
Yeah.
On Give us your handle on social media.
RVRB.
You got that? So all of y'all should be going to it now. And this showcased where? On which platform? On what platform?
Netflix.
Right? So congratulations to you, Cloud Chaser.
True library music.
Look at it.
I know that Gio's talking about production music and library music.
Yeah.
There is more than one way to get saved. Library music. Another way to
See, library
music.
Yep. And Al would have touched on that too.
Yeah.
Yes.
And next up on those who did it.
Da-da-da-dum.
Over to you.
It's right alone. Tell me, can you feel it?
Our parents promised us they'd take us to the island where they got married. We knew the island would be fun, but we never knew you'd meet a special friend that would change your lives forever. Our buddy Echo, the dolphin.
Oh my gosh.
Dolphins usually travel in pods, like a family.
They need social interaction. I honestly think it could be loneliness bringing him this close to us.
Can we bring it back to its family? An idea.
It seems a little far-fetched though, right?
Not after everything you guys taught us.
I say let's do it.
Yeah!
There he is!
Apart! You're in Tenerife! Look!
If we don't do something, no one will.
Let's
go! We're almost there! Dolphin Kick.
Right, so they just give away the name of the show, so I'm not going to ask you all that. Dolphin Kick, but where did it Where is Dolphin Kick being seen?
Platform.
What platform?
Yes.
You trying to be a comedian in the back there, huh?
It's on Netflix.
It's on Netflix, yes. And who is singing?
Who's singing? Aaron
Duncan.
Yeah,
man.
That's good.
I feel like they should get a few free drinks upstairs when we go to the networking. Yeah? A free drinks courtesy Brighton's.
Can I say free drinks to everybody who knows too much? All right. Good that I say that. All right, and our next one in terms of those who did it. Over to you. Oh, okay. All right.
All right. So we don't have that video to load up.
But we can still mention it.
Go right ahead.
It would have been Training to the Bone on Atlanta by David Rudder. And that would have been 2022. And we have one other person we want to acknowledge.
And we have one other person that we couldn't get a video clip for, which is Olatunji's Oye, which showed on Netflix, See You Yesterday, producer Spike Lee for that show. This is 2019. Yeah. So the actual idea for this, which got foiled like a couple days before this turned into this, was to get the actual artists to come here and talk about, like how Marcus just did, to talk about their experience. And then when they heard that, you know, this opportunity came through for them, how, you know, the emotions, the whatever, how it came through. So he just mentioned a different way instead of the traditional publisher's route that they think could have, you know, landed. Right, so that was the idea, but everybody decided they need to go to Canada and they need to go to where? Miami and whoever to perform, so nobody in the country.
Except
Marcus, right?
So thank you, Marcus.
So thank you, Marcus, for being in the country.
And being in the room as well, which is so important.
So yeah, we don't have any questions for this segment, but here's what I'm going to put Leslie on the spot. We have two more books to give away.
All right.
As we wait for our international guests to come back down so that we can close and then head up to the rooftop for Six Well. For those who purchase passes for that and those who have on the listing for that, you're going up to the rooftop afterwards for 6 o'clock for the networking mixer. Right, so books.
All right, so I have to come up with a question.
You could stay right there, yes. Yay. Come up with the questions
easy,
for them.
Easy one.
We have two more books.
Okay, so the first person who can put the hand up.
Whatever you want to do.
List 3 out of the 4 names mentioned here based on those who did it. 3. DK. All right.
All right, Leslie, we have to come up with something else. We have our next one.
Where did you went to school?
Out of the 5 listing that we called, 3 of the same platforms were mentioned. Well, 3 times one platform was mentioned. What is the main platform being mentioned? Netflix. That was so easy.
I feel like that's the only one that we remember. Here you go.
Congratulations.
All right, wait. So I have one other book to give away. This is technically right now because it's not in the country yet.
Come and sing 2 lines of one of these songs in there. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. You see, it was a good one. Yeah.
So here's what one person I want to come up to the podium right here, and you're basically gonna say what you learned over this 3 days.
So the first thing I learned was that
you need to believe in your own source more. You need to have self-belief. That's one of the main ingredients of becoming a success in any endeavor in the creative industries. And you have to put yourself out there. You have to ask from the best people within your network and always seek to expand your network. And in addition to that, be consistent with representing yourself in the way that you want to be perceived by others. Also, you have to have the humility or lack of ego to not be afraid of revising your work, not be afraid of developing yourself in different directions and exploring new avenues for the expression of that talent. Am I missing anything? Good?
No. I know, right? I'm like, give the girl the book.
Film and the television are two different media, two different ways of processing stories, and you shouldn't think that you could do the same thing for all of them. There are opportunities for each, but they are different. So when you're creating for them, you have to think of the goal, the end in mind, as DK would have said on this last day.
Lovely. Wow. Thank you, Nzinga. So the name of the book that Nzinga gets, when we get the book, you'll get the book, is Touring and Mental Health, the Music Industry Manual, edited by Tamsin Embleton. So just to tell you that that book is blazing the country tours right now all over. It is recently released. It is being touted in all of the, what is the name of the venue? All of Live Nation's venues. So they purchased like thousands of the books and put them in the dressing rooms to station there for all of the artists across their venues, as well as the Music Therapy Association just purchased up a whole set of them. So, you know, because as we went through the 3 years of stress and torture, a lot of persons have come out not unscathed from it. So they put out this book, and this is not music therapists doing this book, but actual therapists writing for musicians, right? So if you can't afford to go to therapy, they literally compiled an entire book for you to kind of self-help yourself through touring and the stresses of that. So Nzinga, congratulations to you, my dear.
All right.
How many Bryden Sampas do we have to give away? Three Bryden Sampas. Okay, so here's what. So Bryden's, who is one of our very gracious sponsors, has put together three hampers. In the room, who are all the artists that took place and performed in the showcases? Oh. Ole looking like Ole, kind of half shy to put up your hands, you know. Marcus, you're not counted. Right. Okay, so to those artists that just put up your hands, across the 3 days, list all of the headliners. First hand to go up. The headliners, the headline acts. Right, so Daniel.
Right, so day one, Miguel Teja.
Uh-huh.
Brave Boy, and day 3 tonight, we'll be called
Boy. Aye, 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 that's what we're talking about. Right, so Mariella, we have one Bryden hamper accounted for. Who do you want to shout the next one to?
I should. Do we have any filmmakers here in the room? Right, I'm not gonna say we have just because, right? We have two filmmakers in this space. We have two put up their hand. Three filmmakers. Can I ask them to go and talk about what was the main thing that stood out to you as a filmmaker in relation to music and film? First person to answer.
To the podium.
To the podium.
Hi everyone. As a filmmaker, what stood out to me is that I need to get all of your contacts while making music. I made sure I put your music in our films. That's what But so in preparation for that, please organize all your metadata, please. Thank you. And then Insta. Blessings. Thank you.
Thank you. All right, and our third hamper. Now, it has some rules to this third hamper. Do not lie, because we can validate in our back end of computer if you did or didn't. Who purchased passes for all 3 days of the Reverb experience? Hi, yay, yay. All right. So the first hand to go up was Tony.
Yes.
So congratulations, Tony. You just won a hamper from Brian's.